everybody, this is Tina. Welcome to my video today, you guys. Today is Tuesday, and in the past I have done Project Life by Stampin' Up! Tuesdays. It's kind of what I shared on Tuesdays, and since our contract with Becky Higgins ended and we launched our new product called Memories and More, I've not done a lot with the product, or and I haven't really shared with you guys, partly because I was trying to figure out the product and what, you know, what I liked about it, or, you know, whatnot. And I've had some struggles with it. Here is the Memories and More Perfect Days card pack, and that's what I'm pulling out right here, and I wanted to show you guys. I have really struggled with this product. I'm gonna be really honest. I'm not loving our first go around with this product, and because of that, I've really struggled, and I have not really tried to dive in and use it. The whole point of our Memories and More product is that it will coordinate more with our regular product in our with our card making. So that's kind of the idea, that we would have this product and then it would coordinate more with our entire line of product, and then you can use it for memory keeping, or you can use it for card making or tags, or you know, just the different things that you're already doing. So with that said, I have certainly struggled with this product. I'm not loving our first go around of designs that we have. This is the Perfect Days is one that I do like more than the other ones. To be quite honest, the other ones I don't like at all, and I haven't purchased them. And I always like to be honest with you guys, because my whole thought behind memory keeping is that we keep it simple, but we make it meaningful. And that's what I do with my Simply Documented group. And it's what I want to do in sharing with you guys this, the different products that we have and that we offer. So these card kits come with a couple specialty items, a couple sticker sheets, a couple overlays, a couple different things. So the Memories and More items that are in the holiday catalog are definitely, I really love. And I feel like it takes a couple catalogs to kind of work out what is the best for the product. And again, like the color schemes in the other cards, I just don't like anything about it. And I'm just gonna be honest with you guys and tell you that I don't like any of the other card kits that we carry. This is one that I do like, and I will grab a couple more of. I love that it's more everyday stuff, currently, happy little life. So on Tuesdays, what I want to be able to do with you guys is share with you some memories and more ideas and things that I'm working on. And this week I'm excited. I'm going to use this card. I wanted to talk to you guys about the Memories and More, but I want to do a traditional layout, and I want to show you guys how you can feature some of your Project Life items into a traditional page. We're going to do a 12 by 12 page, and we're going to use some designer paper from Stampin' Up!, which again, our dies and designer paper and our cardstocks and inks and stamps, we are moving into a place where we really want to be able to use all of this product for everything that you're doing. So you don't have to have a bazillion different lines of product. So the other really fun thing is that I got a silhouette a couple months ago. It was probably like 2 months ago, and I've not used it. I'm really intimidated by it, first of all, and then I hadn't had time. But over the weekend, I dove in and I used my silhouette for the first time. And you guys, I made these flowers. They're to hang up in my craft room. This paper is some close to my heart paper that is retired. And it's a little bit hard to see. I probably should have done like every other layer a different color, like a solid color and then the flowers. But in person, they're really pretty. They're dimensional. I made a few different sizes and I've hung them up in my craft room. I have recently finished up working on some major items in my craft room. And this fall, I'm going to give you guys a craft room update. But with that said, I also did some cuts on my silhouette. And we're going to put together this page using some cuts from my silhouette get some designer paper, a Project Life card, and then a stamp set and a few other embellishments. So let's get started. I know it's a lot. I've given you guys a lot of information. We've talked a lot about some different things, but I want to be honest with you guys and share with you honestly where I'm coming from and why I'm using the product that I'm using. So from now going forward on Tuesdays, what I'm going to do is dive in and try to do some memories and more. We'll use more of these cards. I'll dive in and do some projects with this, some Project Life stuff. And then also you'll see me getting out some stamp sets and die sets and using some designer paper to do some more mixing of the traditional layouts to the Project Life. And I would love to know what you guys think about that. If you guys have any ideas or what your thoughts are on our new memories and more, I love to have discussions with you guys about these things. So I'm starting off with just a 12 by 12 piece of pattern paper. It has this really cute cameras on one side and then this yellow stripes on the other. And then what I'm going to do is I just pulled out another piece of designer paper that is from the same pack. And I love that Stampin' Up! Lets you know what colors coordinate with whatever you're working with. And I'm just using my ATG gun. And we're just going to attach.
You could definitely do it this way if you wanted. I'm doing it this way. I know it's kind of hard. That shows up on camera is a little bit hard from the stripes.
So I have three photos here from the summertime. And I've pulled out some Bermuda Bay as a accent color. Anytime I can use Bermuda Bay, you guys, I'm excited to do so. I took this photo and I took a half inch off each side. And then my photo, my mat for my photo is just 4x6. And then on these photos of the girls, I just took a quarter inch off one side. And then I made it 5 inches. So it's 5 inches by 3 3/4 and then added a mat to that. These are some photos that I took the last weekend of summer before we went, well, not the last weekend of summer, but last weekend of summer break. And I was playing around with my new iPhone 7 and it has this great photo feature mode and I was trying it out. Sorry about the glare, you guys. So what I want to do is just layer these down here just pretty much like this. That's how my layers are going to be. So a couple things that I cut from the Silhouette are these cards right here. So the Silhouette is a little bit dangerous because I have access to a bazillion different things and they're like 99 cents a piece. And I found myself just going, oh, like I want this and add that to my card and I'll take this. So it's a little bit dangerous. I'm trying to reel it in. So I did this. This came with four. One said June. There was a card that said June and then one said August. And I cut one out in yellow and then one out in Bermuda Bay. And then the other thing that I have here is I have a sun. And then I have the summer, and the sun is meant to go over the summer, and the summertime is from that card. So I'm going to go ahead and pull these pieces off, and then I'll come back and I'll show you how we're going to assemble this page really easily, and it's going to make a great addition to our family album. Okay, guys, I am back, and I have attached everything so that it's all glued down. You didn't really need to see me do that part of it, but let me walk you through what I did. So I took my summer cut right here, and I put it down here at the bottom. I moved the picture of Andrew a little bit up to accommodate this, and then I did my summer and my sun right there, and I've inked the edges of that. So I've just taken a sponge dauber, just like this, and then our ink, and I've just inked around the edges. So I used Bermuda Bay, Crushed Curry, and then the black. This would be the basic black that's in there. So then I just layered that down. I just did that flat. You could totally pop it up. You could run it through the Big Shot and add some texture to this. I just kept it really simple. I have my photo mats on here in the photos. And then for Kayla's photo, I popped it up a tiny bit. So there's some dimension and there's a reason I did that and I didn't just do it flat. And we'll talk about that when we get over here. So then here's the photo of Violet. And then same thing, I used my ink and inked around the edges of this. I put some Bermuda Bay cardstock behind the summertime. And the only thing is that I don't know,
I don't know, if I had thought this through more, I might not have used this card. I might have used the July card and put the yellow behind it. I had kind of wanted the yellow card. Maybe I should have cut this in yellow. Maybe that would have been a better thing. But it says summertime, and then it says summer down here. So it's kind of, I don't know. I didn't think, I was trying not to think this through. And I'm just putting this over here so the glare will not blind you guys. I didn't think it through. I kind of just dove into this layout and really wanted to share with you guys my process. So the next thing I'm going to do is I have this little embellishment and it says live it up, and I'm going to use this. It just was a part of my stash. I have had it for a while and I want to use it. So we're going to put this in the corner here, and then I have these. Now, these are tags. They are like the tags that you get that would have a key ring on them, and then you can put a number and like have, you know, a bunch of tags with keys on them or different things. I just take the ring off, and then I use these in my Project Life album all of the time. So the great thing is that a 1-inch punch will cover that. So then what I'm going to do is just add this to one of these circles. And then I like to just pop these up on pop dots, which is why I left this flat and why I popped up the picture of Kayla. So I have dimension on both sides. And I like to go ahead and use two dimensionals. And I'm gonna layer that right there. And now that's popped up. It ties in my designer paper from over here. And then I was thinking about using this as a journal card. But now I really don't have anywhere to put it. So what I did is I trimmed this down. I decided I did want to try to figure out how to use it. I trimmed it down and then I cut a flag out of the edge, and it's really close there. You can see it's a little bit, kind of a little bit off. But what I'm going to do is hang it right down here and overlap it on this photo, since I overlapped something on this photo. And then I took the rest of the grid card right here, and what I'm going to do is just add some ink to the edge of this, and I'm just using my ink pad and just running it along the edge. Just like that. And then what I'm going to do is attach it right here. And this is where I'll put my journaling. So that will be my whole page. The other thing that I could do is I have some of these glimmer enamel dots. Let's use some of these. Okay, so that's all finished. I added a few of those enamel dots. And that completes my page. There will be a photo over on my website, you guys, and all of the supplies that I used are listed in the YouTube description below. I hope that you guys are okay with me sharing my honest opinion about products. I never want to just share something in hopes that you'll just purchase them. I really want them to work for you guys, and I really want to be able to share honestly my opinion. It doesn't mean that I don't love the Memories and More concept and the line that Stampin' Up! Is doing. I am very excited about us being able to do that, and I actually have had the opportunity to talk to people from the home office and be involved in giving my feedback on the product. So I hope that that will be helpful to Stampin' Up! And as always, you guys, I love Stampin' Up! Product, and I love being able to do this. So from now on, Tuesdays will be Memories and More, and we will dive into lots of different Memories and More, the product and different layouts than doing Project Life or traditional pages like this. And I hope that it's something that you guys will enjoy, and we can have fun documenting the moments of, you know, our everyday life. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this. I will be back on Thursday to share with you guys. And don't forget that the holiday catalog is going live on Friday. There was no customer email sent out this Tuesday because I'm waiting to send it out on Friday. So I'm here, you guys, and creating and having fun. And I'm so excited to dive in with this with you guys. I hope you're having a wonderful day, and I will chat with you later.